So we're finally starting to see some stuff from the Alice in Wonderland sequel, Through the Looking Glass, set for March of next year. Another little movie comes out that month, Batman v Superman, Dawn of Justice. That comes out at the beginning of the month, though. This one at the end of the month. But yet again, we have a Disney Warner Brothers face-off, so to speak. But while we've seen plenty from Batman v Superman, this one's really been kept under wraps until this weekend with the D23 Expo, where they're putting a major focus on this film. In fact, so much so with a floor display and these posters that have debuted, you can see one here, that I wouldn't be surprised if we get some kind of trailer or teaser with the live action panel tomorrow at D23. So we'll see. We'll keep our fingers crossed. Now, I loved this first film, and it's actually one of Disney's first films to reach $1 billion. It kicked off the whole live action fairy tale craze, but I think that while it's famous for its box office numbers, I think it's also famous in a way for the very negative reaction that so many viewers had to it, even though so many people paid to see it. And I think that it's right up there with Maleficent, interestingly written by the same screenwriter, Beauty and the Beast's Linda Wolverton, and I think it'll be very interesting to see if these two films can sustain themselves as franchises and not just one-offs, because again, there was such a knee-jerk negative reaction by many people to the films. And I think that it's probably not a coincidence that both films have very strong feminist undertones, and so I wonder if that has anything to do with it. But I really love the first movie, and I'm very excited to discuss these reveals right now. Now, at the end of Alice in Wonderland, she came back. It's a wonderful film. If you haven't seen it, at least give it a shot. But at the very end of the movie, she decides that she's not going to get married. I said feminist undertones and not so undertony. But she's going to instead try and go into her, you know, her family business, and that's trading. And she goes on a ship to China to explore those trade routes and to learn the business, learn the biz. It's her internship. I think it's interesting that right away with this this new film, they're focusing on her. It's called her, let's see, we also have a picture of the outfit from D23 on the convention floor, her Mandarin outfit, and it's the one she's wearing in the poster as well. So I think that strong focus is very interesting indeed. Just on a side note, we won't talk about it too much here because we'll wait till a trailer drops, but while this film has retained its costume designer, Colleen Atwood, as you can see, there's a very strong through line between the two films with the look of the characters' costumes, at least. It'll be interesting to see how else it changes, because while it also has the same screenwriter, Linda Wolverton, the director has changed. We've gone from Tim Burton to James Bobbin, who directed the first Muppets movie, so he's going to be handling the directing. And then they lost their overall production designer, Robert Stromberg, who went on to direct Maleficent, actually. It's all in the family here at Disney with their live-action fairy tales. And he's been replaced, I have my notes here, by Dan Hanna. And Dan Hanna is the production designer, or was the production designer, on the Hobbit film. So he certainly has a history with this kind of intricacy, but not... it'll be interesting to see if he goes full fantasy with Disney or if he grounds a little bit, as I think the Peter Jackson's Tolkien films were. I think they were a little more realistic than what Disney's doing. But on this poster, before we get into the Mandarin elements, I just also want to comment on the Salvador Dali reference with the melting clocks. I think that's really great. Sacha Baron Cohen is playing a character, the character of Time. I don't know if it's Time, like, you know, like Time itself, or he's just named Time, but you can see, even though he's not in the posters, that motif very much is. But I appreciate the strong artistic reference. It would be wonderful if these films were also somewhat educational as well, even beyond the source material. You know, of course, Lewis Carroll's famous novel. I believe he wrote a couple of Alice stories. I like the poster. The lack of focus on characters is interesting, especially considering the fact that the focus was so strongly on characters for the first ad campaign, for the first movie. But let's get into this costume, which I just absolutely adore. It's funny, Clover Canyon just released a bunch of... you know, their fall line, and they have an outfit that looks very much like this. So maybe Colleen Atwood is also really keyed into what's just popular in fashion right now. But it's an amazing costume. I like the mishmash of patterns. It doesn't quite seem to go together, the skirt and the shirt, but yet it does at the same time. You know, and the bottom almost seems like a tartan to me. And the colors are so much more vibrant in the poster than they are in the mannequin, which I find very, very interesting. But I think this costume looks fantastic. I love the shoes. They're a mix of Mandarin-style shoes, very much of the East. But then, of course, they have the buttons on them, which, of course, is very Victorian England. So it's a really good mishmash, not only of color and pattern, but also, of course, of cultures. So I think that's just absolutely fantastic. And I think that the leaves around the neck are also just really great. It has a little bit of an armor professional look to it. She's trying to start her own business, but I think at the same time, it's still very feminine. Fantastic. Really great costume. Then the other costume we get a good look at here, and you can see I'm putting this along with the other poster, which is the reverse, and it's the Mad Hatter. And there, how telling is that? That for this one, they don't have Johnny Depp, his face at all. It's just the idea of the figure. Now, maybe to Johnny Depp and his agent, they were like, you're so iconic at this point, Johnny. They don't need to see your face. But of course, let's not forget that Johnny Depp's face sold that first movie almost exclusively. But I think that perhaps even the Disney studio has become aware of the fact that he's a little oversaturated at this point, a little overexposed. So I think to pull back from that a little bit is a good idea. I would also hope that they explore, as it seems to, because you can see this costume, it says this is Young Hatter celebration look. I think it would be wonderful if they were to focus a little bit more on his backstory, because one of the genius things about the first film was how, you know, it focused on the fact that a lot of times, tradesmen like this would go mad because of the chemicals and the materials they were working with. And that's how the Mad Hatter became mad. And I think that's really a clever thing. I'm not quite sure if that was Lewis Carroll's intention originally, but I think Linda Wolverton tried to bring that out, and I would love to see that focused on even more. It's a real-world application, and it grounds the fantasy a little bit. Reese Ifans is playing his father in the movie, so that's why you have a Young Hatter. Although it's interesting, I checked the cast, and you couldn't find a young actor playing a younger version of Johnny Depp, whereas there are actresses cast as younger versions of Helena Bonham Carter and Anne Hathaway. Very interesting. But this is the basic look, of course, sans wig. But it looks great, and of course, you've not only seen it in the first movie, but at a gabillion Halloween parties afterwards. Then the final picture that we have here is a bunch of costumes together, which look really great. They look a little bit more traditional, like the first film, but I just think we should go through them really quickly. That one on the first there on the left, that is Helena Bonham Carter's character, and it says Erasabeths. You know, she's not just the Red Queen. They're trying to get you a little bit here. They're using their given names in the story rather than their titles. So that's the Red Queen, and it says it's her organic armor, sold at Whole Foods. I couldn't help myself, I'm sorry. But I think obviously, maybe it's the idea that the Red Queen doesn't want to wear armor, you know, much like Alice did in the first movie. So I guess a little bit, borrowing a page from Scarlet Overkill's repertoire, she's got a dress that also happens to be armor. So that's a funny coincidence. Then next year, you would think that might be time, but that is actually the Hatter's Adventure Hero look, which, you know, you can see it has a little bit, I think it's interesting that he'll be changing costumes as well. I guess Johnny Depp's like, you gotta let me change costumes. I love it so much. But it does have a little bit of that British explorer aspect to it, so I think that's very interesting. And of course, he has to change hats because that's his job. So I think that looks very nice. It's a little muted, but you can kind of see that he's got high boots on there, and I think I'm sure Johnny Depp with the wig will, plus it as necessary. Then they have Alice's ribbon fantasy look. That doesn't look too fantasy-like to me, actually. It looks much more muted than her Mandarin look. That's the least interesting, I think, of all the costumes. And then the last one there is Anne Hathaway's. It says Miranda's magical gown, which I guess, CGI visual effects will have to do its magic for it, because it just looks like a typical white gown and very similar to what she wore in the first film. So that's our very first sneak peek at Through the Looking Glass. Finally, some stuff for us to devour. And I'm curious, do you like what you're tasting? Or does it still leave a bad taste in your mouth after that first film? And stay tuned. If there is indeed a teaser or a trailer, I will certainly be covering that and any other news that breaks all weekend for D23. All right, you can leave your thoughts down below, and then you can also check out some other episodes right now.